step, 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 step,
step,
step,
step,
step,
step.
Whoa.
Hello, handsome.
Hey, keep moving.
Rattle, 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 rattle. Step, 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 step.
Lex? Tommy? Come on, let's keep moving. So wait, how are you here and in the real world?
Kerplunk?
What do you mean?
So, what's the last thing you remember? I was in the studio working on my script. I think I just figured out what's going on.
Is the next one the finale?
Hey Burros, welcome back to this week's edition of the Burro News. I'm Jason Mack.
And I'm Ezra Hindley. Today is Monday, April 17th, and it is a B-Day. It's been a little over a month since we last seen you, Burros. Since then, we've had some troubling events occur. There was a mass shooting at the Covenant School, killing 3 children and 3 adults.
And with that, we've had many student-led walkouts to the Capitol to protest our current gun laws. In fact, many Hillsboro students have gone to these protests, along with some Burro News students. Here's more from our news team that captured the thoughts and images from our students.
Following the events at Covenant on March 27, just 3 weeks ago, our students have participated in multiple protests on Capitol Hill. The protests are against gun violence and urges Tennessee lawmakers to enforce stronger gun laws.
We are right. Where are we at, Fortune?
Capitol.
Why are we here, Fortune?
To protest.
I'm here with
Abigail Maurice.
Why are you here today?
I'm here today for the kids and for the schools and victims of the shooting and for all future kids.
You here to protest against gun violence?
I'm here today because I think that this is a major injustice. The fact that we have to be here and protest about children getting shot, the fact that children have to go to school and worry about if they're going to make it out alive or not, the fear that is spread across America because of situations like this should have never happened. This is an example of our government not working.
What do you see the outcome of this protest being?
I hope all the people I hope all they know that all these kids are, all these high schoolers, all these colleges, all these adults are here for these kids, and to let them know that they should protect the kids instead of the guns and put the kids first.
That one of the representatives would do something.
And how long do you think it's going to take for that time?
However long it takes. It shouldn't take long.
Over 2,000 students walk out of school to make their voices heard.
What do we want?
Gun control!
What do we want?
Now!
What do we want?
Gun control!
What do we want?
Now!
I think it's a good thing that our students are protesting our gun laws, and I do think they need to be changed.
Yeah, me too. I'm really proud of our Burros for advocating for what they feel is right.
Recently, our juniors and seniors got to learn about what their future could look like when the Opportunity Fair came to Hillsboro. More than 20 colleges and business came to our large gym to showcase their world. Students were able to gather information about summer programs and future jobs that will give them a great career head start to college life.
Recently, we had our annual art showcase where we held live music and theater performances, kids' art making stations, and we had art displays and presentations. Here's a closer look at the event.
Do you think you'll go to prom this year?
Yeah, I think so. I need to get my junior prom experience.
Exactly. Well, if you will be attending prom, just a reminder that it is April 29th at Marathon Music Works through 7 p.m. to 11 p.m. Tickets are $60. And tickets will be on sale April 10th through the 27th in the community room right by the main office. Cash or money order only. They do not accept online payments.
Remember, if you've been suspended in the past three quarters, which also includes the fourth quarter, you are not allowed to purchase a prom ticket. Each junior and senior must purchase their tickets themselves in person. And if you're buying a ticket for somebody who's not an HHS student, there's a required permission slip that you need to fill out, have completed, and also be signed by Dr. Pelham and the other person's school principal. A copy of the person's photo ID is also required.
Prom is right around the corner, and you know what that means? Buying expensive suits and looking expensive. But do we really want to spend all that money? Is that driving you away? Luckily, for Hillsborough students, we have an official prom shop. Every day during second lunch on the second floor, right by the Burro Brew. Not sure what to wear? Come by the prom shop.
What's going on, Burros? It's your favorite administrator, Mr. Owens, and we are back after a long time coming with another Owens Report. So, number one, over the next 2 weeks, we will have testing coming up. So if you're in any EOC course, such as biology, integrated math, any of those, it is imperative that you get to school on time and ready to test. These are a big part of your grade, 15% to be exact. So please make sure you come to school on time, ready to go, ready to test. Other than that, thank you for all you all do. This has been a great month. We are coming to the end of the year, so please make sure you remember the finish line, especially my seniors. I want to see all my seniors graduate on May 23rd. Once again, it's your favorite administrator, Mr. Owens, and that's the Owens Report. Y'all have a good day.
Alright, which movie character would you be and why?
I would be Tom Cruise from Top Gun Maverick because, I don't know, I feel like ever since I watched that movie I wanted to join the Air Force.
Which movie character would you be and why?
I would be Coraline because the entire movie she was in a state of delusion and I'm Delulu, so.
Which movie character would you be and why?
Jordan Belfort. I want to be super rich and be super cool with people.
I'm going to be Walter White because I want to get cancer and sell meth.
All right, which movie character would you be and why?
I would be Nina from Black Swan because I'm just like mad dedicated and like super talented.
I'd be Katniss because I was her for Halloween and because I think that I'd be really good with a bow and arrow.
All right, what movie character would you be and why?
I would be Nacho Libre because he's hilarious and he has amazing wrestling skills.
Solid.
Johnny Sins, he's a jack of all trades. He does everything.
That's a really good one.
Thank you for joining us, bros. My name is Ezra Hindley.
And I'm Jason Meck. We'll see you on next week's episode. On the 24th in the integrated math EOCs on the 25th, 26th, and 27th.
Make sure you get to school on time and have your computers charged, bros. Of course. Good luck.
Good luck.
They're just like,
hot dog. Wait, what? Literally. You said top three hot dog topics. Hey, bros. Welcome back to this week's Bro News. I'm Jason Meck.
And I'm...
How did you mess up your name? To the sky. Man, I'm gonna give you energy to the moon. Stop playing.
Thank you.